origin of the Lasser Glass is unknown, so I can't provide a complete history, but the trail starts in London in 1754. Philip Lasser, the 17th Earl of Leicester, acquired the mirror and hung it over his fireplace. And another precaution. Hi, sweetie, how are you?
Well, I'm checking in, as requested. You all right?
Everything's fine. Oh, I know this is silly to ask, but could you try and call on the hour? It's about 7 past.
Sure.
I'll talk to you in 53 minutes, and I love you. I'm expecting regular calls from my fiancé, Michael Dumont. I told him I'm nervous to be spending time with my recently unincarcerated brother, with instructions to notify the authorities immediately if I do not answer the phone.
In the room.
Nothing personal. So in 1755, Philip Lasser was found at their grand fireplace, burned beyond recognition.
While his estate was dismantled and scattered throughout southern England, one of the family's stewards claimed to see Philip reflected in the mirror, an allegation apparently taken seriously enough to warrant a church investigation into the house. The glass, thereafter known as the Lasser Glass, is sold in public auction in 1758. The next known owner is an American railroad tycoon named Robert Clancy, 1864. Clancy apparently weighed over 300 pounds. In fact, while attending university in Connecticut, he was known as the South Windham Whale.
He hung the glass in his ballroom in Atlanta.
Later that year, Robert Clancy is photographed by a local newspaper and, he's dropped a few pounds. His obit was printed a few weeks later, doesn't list a cause of death. Unfortunately, he and his estate and the glass are presumably destroyed in Sherman's March to the Ocean in 1865. And after that, the glass is lost until it resurfaces in turn of the century New England. The next case of note is Mary O'Connor, 1904. She hung the mirror in her private bathroom. 2 weeks later, her niece Beatrice finds Mary dead in the bathtub. Now, the official coroner's report lists the cause of death as, get this, dehydration. The woman died of thirst while soaking in a full tub for 3 days. The next case of note is Alice Carden in Lake Geneva, Wisconsin, 1943. Neighbors reported hearing screams and loud bangs from the house. The police found the children drowned in a locked cistern. Alice herself was in the nursery, and both of her legs are completely shattered. Her left arm is broken in 4 places, and 6 of her ribs are crushed. In her right hand is a large hammer she's been using to break her own bones, and they find her just as she's going to work on her skull. Her right arm, though, is completely unharmed, because she needed it to wield the hammer. Alice later says she believed she was tucking the children into their beds as she sealed them in the cistern. She never recovers from her injuries, and the family kept several dogs at the farm, including an Australian shepherd for the children.